Hello student, in last class I have introduced some points regarding evaluation of argument. To find the modulus value, the method is clear everywhere, but to find the argument, we have discussed various points in various cases in which a different type of evaluation for theta you will take place. Now here, as per the position of the coordinate system, theta is to be right. So one example I have discussed to you, that was question number 1 of the exercise 5.2. Now in continuation, we are going to attempt some more forms. Now here, in second question, z is available as minus under root 3 plus iota. So here two things are being asked, that is the absolute value, or you can say the modulus value, and its respective argument. So both we are going to make a find it out. First of all, compare with the z is equal to x plus iota y, or ab also you can write, there is no problem. X we can write it as a minus under root 3, whereas your y is your 1, means multiple of 5, whatever you are having, that is to be considered as a 5. Now first of all, it's a modulus value. That means r, or you can say under root x square plus y square. So that you will write as x square means this much plus 1 square, means 3 plus 1, 2. So here r you are getting as a 2. Now here to find out the argument value, first you will define your alpha angle, and on basis of the sine of x and y you will decide about the quadrant system. Now here you see, cos alpha you will evaluate as a absolute of x upon r. That formula in last class I have given to you, means under root 3 upon 2. When you are talking about the absolute value, means you avoid negative sign. Secondly, sine of alpha you will write as a, means 1 upon 2. If you look at these two values, you will see that your answer is coming as, alpha is coming as a pi by 6, means 30 degree. Here you are having a common angle. Sine 30 is 1 by 2, whereas cos 30 is under root 3 by 2. So here alpha you have concluded as a pi by 6, 30 degree. Now here you see, your x is less than 0, whereas y is greater than 0. At that time theta you will evaluate as a second quadrant system, means pi minus alpha. So that will give you pi minus pi by 6. On taking LCM, you will have it as 5 pi by 6. So here the two solution you are having is a modulus value, means r as a 2, and theta is a 5 pi by 6. Be sure that when you are going for evaluation of the theta, its range should be fulfilled. So this way your argument will be evaluated. So for all type of question, your method of evaluation of r and theta will remain same. Here one more thing can be added, that on basis of the evaluated value, this modulus and the argument, find out the polar form of a given complex number. Polar form also we have defined in last class, that was z is equal to r inside the bracket cos theta plus iota sin theta. So only one more thing you have to add, that is substitution of r and substitution of theta in that standard form. So our next category of question is the same. Find out polar form for given complex number. Now here, from question number 3 to 8, we are having the same category. in which each complex number you have to convert in a polar form. So let's try to discuss how it will be. Just look at question number 3, in which your z is available as a 1 minus iota form. Now first of all, r is required and then theta is required to make a conversion of given complex number in a polar form. So let's first aside we write what is the polar form is. So polar form of a complex number z is r cos of theta plus I sin of theta that I have given in the last lecture. So now two terms are required here, that is r as well as theta. So in order to find out these two, we just move now here. First of all, from given complex number, x is equal to 1, whereas y is equal to minus 1. Secondly, r is to be defined as under root x square plus y square. So here, if you go for substitution, that will give you root 2. So here r is root 2. Next, cos alpha we find here, that is your modulus of x upon r. Sin alpha you will find is modulus of y upon r. Modulus of x means 1 upon under root 2. This is sin alpha as a 1 by under root 2. If you look at these two common value, you will find alpha as a 45 degree pi by 4. For both the trigonometrical term sine as well as cos, your 45 degree is 1 by root 2. So if you make them compare and find the common solution, alpha you are getting is pi by 4. Now look at the sine of x and y. Here if you look at the sine of x and y, here x is positive, whereas y is negative. So here it this position of theta in a fourth quadrant. So as x is greater than 0, where y is less than 0, means theta you can evaluate as a minus alpha form. In fourth quadrant, it will be defined as a minus alpha form, means it will be your minus pi by 4. Now substitute in this form, here it is root 2, this is cos minus pi by 4 plus sine minus pi by 4. As such also it can be concluded as answer form, or it can be also written this way, cos minus theta means cos theta only, this is pi by 4, sine minus theta means minus, so minus you can take it as an outside or multiple form. So this way also you can write your final answer form. Both forms are acceptable as a final answer form. So in order to that, let's move towards one more form, that is question number 6, in which only single term is available. That form also I have given to you. Here your z is available as a minus 3 only, means single number you are having, means imaginary term is not present here, its multiple is 0. So or you can express your complex number as minus 3 plus 0 into I. Now first of all we will find out its modulus value, means r under root of minus 3 whole square plus 0 square, obviously it will be 9, means 3. So here its modulus value you are getting as a 3, or r you are getting as a 3. Now we just think about the given complex number form in which your y is 0. So that case also we have discussed, direct also you can find, and if you are not sure you can define your alpha and then theta, that will also give you the same answer form. So here you see, here your z is containing minus 3 plus 0 into I. Here your y is become 0 and x is less than 0. So at that time what we have written, your theta will be turned out as a pi. That from your side also you can evaluate how it will be. Define your cos of alpha under root of x upon r. Under root of x, that means what? 3 upon three, that will give you 1. Sin alpha you can define as a 0 upon anything, means it will give you 0 solution. If you look at this common angle, what will you have? Alpha is 0. At 0 value sin alpha turn as 0, at 0 value cos will turn as 1. So here you can say the alpha will turn out as a 0. Now your x is being a negative quantity, okay, and y is being 0. X is being a negative quantity, so don't think about the y because y already not 0. X is negative quantity means you are in the second quadrant. So theta you will have as a pi minus alpha. Here your pi is 0, so that's why you will get this theta as a alpha form. So that's why this I have directly written, that theta is equal to pi. So if you want to make sure about your solution, you can follow these steps to find out your solution by using the method what up to now we have discussed. Otherwise, with the zero solution, direct you can conclude to the answer form. So here we have written r as well as theta. So just to convert the given complex number in a polar form, so polar form of z is equal to minus 3 is r cos of theta plus iota sin theta. R it was 3 cos pi plus I sin pi. This will be the answer form. Now next, with the different category we are having the last part, that is 8, in which only imaginary part is available, real part is turned as 0. So the reverse condition of this one we are having. So there we will write direct this form, not we are going to discuss all these things, because these things many times we have discussed with the different combination. If you want to discuss, you can write, otherwise it is not necessary to write it. Direct you can conclude to the theta form. Now the next is z is equal to I. So make it convert with the standard form as a z is equal to 0 plus 1 into I. So here your x is 0, where is y is equal to 1. So first of all you will make evaluation of the modulus value. So r means under root 0 square plus 1 square, obviously it will turn to 1. So this is the one solution we are having. Now regarding the solution, now here you see as x is equal to 0 and y is greater than 0. So what will you turn? Theta. Theta we will have as a pi by 2. Now the same method you will implement as we have discussed in the last question. You will conclude about the same. Now the polar form of z is equal to iota is r cos of theta plus I sin of theta. Substitute everywhere, this is 1 itself, this is cos pi by 2 plus I sin of pi by 2. So this way you can define your polar form with a single term available to you. So it was all about the evaluation of the modulus value, argument and conversion of given complex number into a polar form. Now the next point we are going to discuss is a solution of a quadratic equation with imaginary part. So in the beginning of this chapter I told you how this iota term is going to be introduced. When discriminant value means the delta value is negative, so at that time to avoid this negative sign inside the square root, this iota is to be generated. So here with the different quadratic form, we will generate that delta, form your iota, and then write the respective roots. So now the next point is a evaluation of the roots for given quadratic equation. Here in most of the cases we will have imaginary roots. So our next point is a solution of quadratic equations. So with the question itself it will be clear to you, and in general I am writing here the solution form so that also you can understand. General form of the quadratic, we know it is a square plus bx plus c. Already once I have discussed these all things. If a middle term splitting is not possible, discriminant d or delta you will find it out as a b square minus 4ac. On evaluation of the value of a d, plus or minus c, it doesn't matter. So here roots of given quadratic equation r, x is equal to minus b plus minus under root delta upon 2a. So by using this formula form we can find out the roots for given quadratic in which factorization is not possible, or you can say the splitting of the middle term is not possible. So if you are not clear about that, please note it down, this formula form, and this formula form which we are going to implement for the next exercise. So from the exercise question itself it will be clear to you that how imaginary roots we are going to be evaluated. Up to now you have discussed only about the real roots, but now this is a new introduction regarding imaginary roots. So from the question itself it will be clear to you that how roots are imaginary. So move towards the exercise. Question number first itself, you see your equation is available with a two term only, that is x square plus 3 is equal to 0. If x square minus 3, it would be easily we can find out the solution by using factorization method. But here what the problem is, in place of negative sign now you are having plus sign. So how to handle this type of situation? Here no x term is written, so no need to find out delta over here. So direct it will be proceed for the solution form. So let's your given equation is x square plus 3 is equal to 0, x square is equal to minus 3, means x is to be separated out, constant you keep in another hand. In the beginning of the chapter I told you that when you are going to remove this negative sign as a multiple of any of the constant, iota square you can introduce. So here also the same thing we are going to do. This you can write this way, whereas the iota square will be replaced by, or the minus 1 can be replaced as a iota square form. Now go for taking the square root on both the sides. X is equal to plus minus under root 3 iota you are having. So this is giving you two solution as a plus or minus. X is equal to plus under root 3i, or the another one is x is equal to minus under root 3i. As a multiple of a iota here the solution you are getting, that's why it is called imaginary solution. I we have introduced here, that's why it is considered as a imaginary roots of given quadratic form. Any of the equation with the higher order available with the 2, so it is considered as a quadratic. So this way, this is a very simple case we are having. Now we are going to move towards the actual quadratic form in which roots are to be evaluated. So let's move towards the question number 2. In which standard quadratic equation is available. Now this is the question available to us is 2x square plus x plus 1 is a 0. Here again you can see splitting is not available, so delta is to be finded out. Before that, make a coefficient separate over here. Multiple of x square you will treat as a, that is 2. Multiple of x, that is b, and multiple of a constant term as a c. So these are the three terms we make separate. Now evaluate discriminant as a b square minus 4ac. B square means 1, a is 2 and this is 1, so 1 minus 8 means minus 7 here you are having, or it can be written as 7i square. So this is the delta what we are having. Now make this one as a square root, what you will generate? Under root 7i. Now find out the roots of given quadratic one. So roots of given equation R, x is a minus b plus minus under root delta upon 2a. Substitute respective value over here. This is minus 1 plus minus under root 7i. This I is outside this square root, that's why somewhat difference I kept in between. This is 2 into a. A is your 2 here. Now make it sort out. Minus 1 plus minus under root 7i upon 4. So these are the two solutions we are having in a combined form. First we will take a plus sign, another we will take a minus sign in between two terms in a numerator form. So this way roots are to be written down with the imaginary solution. Now next we move towards question number 4. This is minus x square plus x minus 2 is equal to 0. Here you can see first and last term both are available with the negative sign. So negative sign you take a common first. So that is minus sign x square minus x plus 2 is equal to 0. Avoid this negative. Your equation is generated as this way. Now here also you can see the factorization is not possible here because plus is required as the final answer form, in between minus is written. So make the constant separate, a as a 1, b as a minus 1 and c as a 2. So delta we will evaluate as a b square minus 4ac over here. Minus 1 square minus 4 into 1 into 2, 1 minus 8 again minus 7. Means 7 iota square. So delta under root you will give you under root 7i. Now evaluation of x. So roots of given equation x is a minus b plus minus under root delta upon 2a. Substitute respective value, minus minus 1 plus minus under root 7i upon 2a. Minus minus plus, plus minus under root 7 iota upon 2. So these are the two solution you will have with respect to given quadratic form. Now the next case we discuss is question number 7. Under root 2x square plus x plus under root 2 is equal to 0. Now make your constant separate. A is a under root 2, B is a 1, C is a under root 2. Discriminant you find everywhere, the method will remain same. You can your own also make a solution of all type of questions. This is a root 2 into root 2. Root 2 into root 2 will give you 2 only. So this is again minus 7. Means 7 I square. Under root of delta is your under root of 7 I. Now define your x. So roots of given quadratic, that is x is equal to minus b, this is minus b, plus minus under root 7i upon 2a. Here nothing is going to be adjusted, as such you keep your answer form. Now one odd combination here you are having is a question number 9. In ninth one, constant term is being written as a third form. X square plus x plus 1 by under root 2 is equal to 0. So it can be handled in two ways. First, either you go for taking LCM and convert your question in a proper way, or as such also it can be carried out as a solution form. So let's try to find out its a discriminant over here, in which your A will be used as a 1. B is a 1 and C is a 1 by under root 2. Discriminant you will find it out as 1 minus 4 into 1 into 1 by under root 2. This is 1 minus 4 means it can be written as a 2 into 2 upon root 2. 1 under root 2 you can adjust over here as splitting of under root 2 and under root 2. 2 you can split this way. Root 2 cut. Finally, you will have as a 1 minus 2 under root 2 as a discriminant. If you look at the solution of under root 2 values, it is having 1.4 something. So make it multiply with 2, it will be obviously greater than 1. So here you can see that 2 under root 2 is greater than 1. So if you find their difference, it will be less than 0. So this you can write as a minus 2 under root 2 minus 1. So iota you can introduce here for more convenient way. Now find out its a root, or you can say it a square root value also you can define here as a square root of 2 under root 2 minus 1 into iota. This we have converted with the square root form. Now roots of this given quadratic. So here roots of given quadratic, it will be your x is equal to minus b plus minus under root delta upon 2a. Substitute the respective values. B means 1, plus minus under root delta means iota, under root 2 under root 2 minus 1 upon 2a. So the final answer you will have this way. These are the solutions regarding your given quadratic form. So this way you can find out imaginary roots by using the delta form. So try to attend remaining question of this exercise. So in next class I will continue with the miscellaneous exercise, in which all mixed type of questions you will have with different combinations. So till then, solve the remaining question of the exercise 5.3, including some of illustrations. Thank you.